Hello everyone, welcome back to MixFest TV. Hope you're having a great day. In this video, we unbox some pretty rad new gear here next to me. I posted a couple of pictures online asking you guys to guess. There was only one correct guess for one of the two units. And no, it's not a pair. It's two units, two different brands. Same category though. And for one, I received so many requests. Are you gonna review that? Because it's a new unit. It just came out on the market not long ago. But I'm pretty sure everyone will want to hear both of them because they are two amazing units. And these two units came in at a perfect time since Pro Tools with the last update got rid, finally, of the 32 physical I/O limits. So to integrate these two pieces in my setup, I already got another 16A converter from Motu. So I will expand my physical I/Os. And probably I will have to expand the patch LT that I just got from Flock because I have some really cool ideas on how to integrate these two pieces in my setup. We will see that in future videos. But without further ado, let's start with the first one. This is the one that I received so many requests. A lot of people were interested in me reviewing this equalizer. It just came out not long ago. And is, of course, from Holy. This is heavy. From Heritage Audio. And yes, you probably guessed right. This is the Synth EQ. So let's open the box. A letter from Heritage Audio, always nice. And this thing is heavy, which we like. I mean, it's really heavy, like really heavy. We have an external power supply, which is always a good thing. So noise is capped lower. And wow, this EQ looks nice. Here we go. Take a look at this. This is the Synth EQ from Heritage Audio. I'm trying to show you without having the light reflecting too much on it. All right. I'm very, very curious about this EQ. I'm curious to hear how it sounds. You know, if you follow me, I already have two units from Heritage Audio. So this is a brand that I absolutely love. I have the 609 and the Successor, which are absolutely amazing compressors. And both of them, I think pretty much all the Heritage Audio gear have a Neve style output. And if I don't remember wrong, of course, we will do a full review of this one. This one does as well. This is gonna be very interesting to hear because, well, it's basically a unique take on the Bandaxal type of EQ, okay? They call this Synth EQ stays for, I have to read, stereo asymptotic equalizer. And that is because of the shape of the curves. Okay, of the shells that this EQ has. We can take a look at the front panel. So first of all, this is a dual mono stereo and mid-side equalizer. It's both for mixing, although it's probably more targeted for mastering, but of course is just as great for mixing or single tracks. So we have, like I said, mirror controls, and let's start with the buttons here. We have an on button here, a mid-side button, so that's great because it has a mid-side encoder built in already, and then bypass left and right. And the layout, I have to say, it's a little bit surprising. I was a little bit surprised at the beginning because usually on all my EQs, I have the highs on the, looking at the unit on the right, okay? And as you go on the left, you have the lower bands. This is kind of backward. So we have the filters here, okay? High pass and low pass. So the small knob inside and the outer knob here. And then we have the high frequencies, which are these two red knobs. By the way, we have Marconi knobs, which we all love, and they are build quality of this thing is great, like all the Heritage Audio gear. All the knobs on this unit are switches, so that's why it's also perfect for mastering. So you have perfect recall. All of them are switches. Filters, frequency selection and gain. But let's see what it has. So we have the frequencies for the highs. They go 24, let me read, 24, 20, 15, 12, 10, and 8. All right, which is pretty cool. I love the 24. And then we have the gain knob here, the other red one, and this goes in step of 1 dB. okay? But they also put a plus 0.5 dB button, okay? So you can actually turn this into a half dB step, which is great, again, for mastering. And then you also have a cut, because this gain knob can be either cut or boost, not both of them, okay? I think this is great, especially the half gain button, so the half dB button step. This makes it very precise, very easy to control. Again, perfect for mastering. Then we have the low band. Frequencies are 20, 60, 110, 220, 360, and 470. All right, you can see it here. That's pretty cool. And the same for the gain knob for the lows, it's 1 dB steps. And again, you have the half dB button and the cut. Same mirrored in the other channel. Same for the filters. I didn't mention the filters. The filters, we have the high pass filter that goes from 15, then 22, 47, 82, and 160 right here. And it's the outer knob, I think. And then the low pass filter goes 30, 22, 18, 12, and 10. I really like these frequency choices. Love that the low cut starts at 15, not too high, perfect for modern music. Absolutely love that the high cut starts at 30, then we have 22 for both. I really, really like the frequency choices for filters. And actually, I only had my drummer equalizer that had filters. My SPL PQ doesn't have filters, and nor the API 5500. So very good addition to my setup with the filters, which I didn't have. These have, like I said, switches, so perfect recall. I can't wait to hear this in action. Both of them have features that I was missing with all my other EQs, and they complement each other, not just between these two, but between all the others. So you see how important is the context. When people ask me, oh, what should I buy first, or should I buy this or that? Well, what else do you have? Because for a professional setup that is already extended, when you want to integrate new things, you just don't buy random, and you don't buy something because, oh, it just came out. You try to fill the voids that you have and just make your final result better, your workflow faster, and more enjoyable as well. And all these have different colors, different belts, different shapes, different gain ranges. And if I look at them now, I'm so covered for everything. Stay tuned, because we are gonna do videos for both of them, and let me know what you think in the comment down below. Thank you for watching. Check the info box for all my mixing courses, discounts, and free plugins, and all that. Subscribe if you haven't already. Stay safe. See you next time. Hands on my neck, hands grip my throat, lift me up.